Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hi students, good morning to everyone. Today, this video, you will get clarity about sexual termination. Whether you remember, I think so you remember, in the previous video, we discussed about the sexual determination topic only in the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Sorry, chromosomal theory of sexual determination that we seen. Apart of that, we want to discuss about the genetic balance theory and haplodiploidy. Correct? Na? So, this video I would like to explain about genetic balance theory and then haplodiploidy. These two concepts. Concept you will be get clarity in this video. Let me start today video session. Students, paranga, pointer place, sexual determination. That sexual determination tells about a new offspring, a newborn baby, sex determined by the which factors. That in the first thing, chromosomal theory, in the previous video, we discussed four different cases. In that four different cases, that mean male heterozygous condition or female heterozygous condition, by that AAXX, AAXO one condition, it will be seen in the grasshoppers. So here number of chromosomes are differ in the male and females, and AAXX, AAXY such a type of sex determination we seen in human beings and Drosophila. Okay, this is a chromosome number is not a change, the chromosome number is equally. But the thing is, structure of chromosome is different. These two are under male heterogamy, and then here AAZZ and AAZO, AAZZ and AAZW. In the first case, chromosome number is different, and then structure is different in the second one. Okay, but these two are belongs to female heterogamy. That means a female act as a heterogametic condition. That we seen in the last video. And then come to the next one, genetic balance theory. That genetic balance theory observed in the Drosophila melanogaster. Sir, just now you said about the Drosophila is a best example in the male heterogamy AAXX, AAXY. So, but here later some of the insects he observed that these genetic balance theory, that Drosophila is one of the arthropoda in insect. So later he given the some clarity about the Drosophila melanogaster in the genetic balance theory explanation. According to the genetic balance theory, what they conveying to us mean here, Y chromosome is not a significant role in the sex determination. Up to our knowledge, what we understand, Y chromosome is a plain important role in the male sex, that we discussed, correct? No? But in the Drosophila melanogaster, experimented by the Bridges scientist, the conclusion about these genetic balance theory by the Bridges, what he is conveying means Y chromosome does not involving in the any sex determination. Here sexual determination depends upon the X chromosomes and autosomes. Basically autosomes are normal chromosomes. Normal chromosomes not at significant role in the sexual determination. But what he concluded mean, some of the genes located on the autosomal chromosomes, that gene percentage is playing important role in the sex determination. So here the Drosophila melanogaster bridges is given the clarity. The sex of the individuals is determined by the balance between the, it is a between, it balance between the genes for femaleness located on the X chromosome, located on the X chromosome. So just now I said, the genes located on the X chromosome, along with that maleness is controlling by the autosomal genes. So what we believe that is not applicable to the all the organisms. What we are believing, Y chromosome is a significant role to create the male characteristics. But in the some of the insects wise, that Y chromosome is a insignificant. So here that X chromosome located genes are regarding to the femaleness it will causes, and male characteristics are controlling by the autosomal genes. That is a thing. Okay, so that expression like this: the ratio of number of its X chromosome and that its autosomal sets. That means if any one individual in Drosophila, sex determination depends upon the that individual contains the how many number of X chromosomes, and then how many number of sets of autosomes are there based on that sex determination is determined. Okay, so that mathematical formula, sex index is equal to number of X chromosomes by number of sets of autosomes. Here but sex determination of that organism, Y chromosome discussion illa inga. So that is a more important. The finally a simple way conveying of the concept here, Y chromosome is not a significant. The ratio between the how many number of X chromosomes and how many number of sets of autosomes are existed in that animal cell, Drosophila body, that will be deciding factor to the sex index. Okay, so for examination of this one, Bridges studied their offsprings resulting. Okay, they take in the sum of the Drosophila male and the females. The Drosophila melanogaster lifespan is very less now. Okay, within the 3 weeks, 2 weeks or 3 weeks. So within that they can able to germinate the offsprings and then they will die. So by studying, by resulting of their offsprings result, studying sex determination, they understand one thing. Some of the abnormal conditions, in the gametogenesis process will not occur properly by the problem of the non-disjunction. You know that meaning, what is the meaning of the non-disjunction? Already in the board explanation wise I said, non-disjunction means in the meiosis process, chromosome number want to reduce, correct? Half of the chromosomes are want to reduce. So at that time chromosomes are segregated in the both sides. So chromosome number will reduce in the coming cells, I mean which are the cells are origin from the mother cells. So that gametogenesis process time proper lack of division, that nothing but non-disjunction, it contains the abnormal chromosomes. So that only in the bracket I mentioned here, failure of the paired chromosomes to segregate or separate during the anaphase. Failure of the paired chromosomes to segregate or separate the during the anaphase of the meiosis condition. Meiosis time only na reductional division occurs. So when that non-disjunction process is happens in the or failure of the segregation of the chromosomes, that resulting aberrant gametes, that means abnormal condition. That abnormal condition gametes in the form of the aneuploidy. Aneuploidy means which is the condition of chromosomes cannot form the equal number of chromosomes. That means it will not produce the separated chromosomes. So that means we can't separate the equally. Okay, both sides it will not produce the equal number of chromosomes. So that's why that karyotype containing with expressing in the form of the 2n plus 1, 2n minus 1. So that means along with the diploid condition, maybe one extra chromosome is added, one more. So if one extra chromosome added means automatically what will happen when the segregation of that one, again it will be one side will be one extra chromosome, one side one less than opposite side. Okay, so that will be happen here 2n minus 1. That means it lost one chromosome. So the one of the pair of chromosomes, lack of one chromosome, it is also not yet from the equal number of equal set of the chromosomes. So such a type of condition we call as a aneuploidy. For example, diploidy condition paranganana, diploidy condition onwards haploid condition gametes will produce. Okay, tetraploidy onwards again diploid conditions gametes will produce. So but here aneuploidy means does not segregate uniformly, equally. That is a thing. So that karyotype 2n plus 1 and 2n minus 1. So finally, this is the result. For understanding wise, I make one pinnate board. See, if you take female organism, that female organism condition AAXX and male organism AAXY. AAXY. These segregation time, basically in the meiosis tag segregation time, both sides equally want to separate. AX, AX want to produce, AX, AY want to produce. Male as usually segregation happens very, as usually it is nicely happened, but AAXX, this condition, if not by the non-disjunction, the chromosome separation is abnormal. So one side AAXX, AAX, another side only A. So here one side having the one extra chromosome, that only indicates 2n plus 1, or here instead of the 2n, if you use the n means that will indicates a haploid condition. Here 2n is a diploid condition. So here meiosis time, that sets of number of chromosomes are lost one their chromosomes. So that is a AAXX, one side extra chromosome, another side XO, O indicates a lack of one chromosomes. That only here I mentioned AAXX, AAAO. In male as usually meiosis occurs. So by the mingled or the fertilization process, if you take in the pinnate board AX, AY sperm cells here, AX, AO gametes here, as ovas. The fertilization process AXX kadana na this one. So AAXXX, 3Xs are there. Okay, so AAXX condition diploid, along with the diploid condition one extra X chromosome is there. As like AAXXY, and then AAXO, AAXO. Here, according to the observing of these pinnate board, here X chromosomes, all are X chromosomes. We confirm it about that. Here, what it will come? It is a female because of it is containing the X chromosomes. And then here AAXXY. By seeing these why, what we determine, this is the male organism. Unfortunately, Y chromosome containing organism also belongs to female character, female one. So what you understand, from that onwards, what we are understand, here Y chromosome is not a significant role. So this is a female, and then come AAXO. AAXO time, what will happen mean, here there is no any Y chromosome, even though it is a male one. So Y chromosome is significant for in the sex determination. Here AAYO, this is the condition, this is a sterile. Okay, whatever it is. So here Y chromosome is not a significant. Finally, sex determination depends upon the X chromosome and number of sets of autosomes. For these conclusion wise, in the second column, I will explain the second continuation. See, in the second column, he did experiment by the triploid drosophila. See, here in the bottom of the first column, they taken the triploid. Triploid means three sets of chromosomes are there, AAA XXX. Sometimes it will be maybe chances by the non-disjunction process. Okay, now I will explain in the next column. You will get why this type of triploid condition will become. By the these triploid condition of the females, by the non-disjunction of gametogenesis time, it produces the abnormal gametes. That abnormal gametes are AX condition and AAXX and AAXAXX. These are the abnormal gametes. Normal gamete AX, along with that maybe three extra gametes will be produced. Now by the these abnormal female ovas, eggs, it may be produced some different type of karyotypic organisms. That karyotypic, based on that karyotypic, whether that organism male or female, we want to know. So here these female gametes, if you filled in the pinnate board, if you filled in the pinnate board, these are the four: AX, AAXX, AAX, AXX. This is the causing by the happened by the non-disjunction process. And in male, as usually, if it is happened the normal disjunction process or meiosis, sperm cells are containing with AX and then AY. Here I see symbols here are mentioned. This is the male and this is the female. Okay. Then if these sperm cell, AX sperm cell mingled with AX ova egg, AAXX will be caused. And then next, these the same sperm cell, if you may be fertile by the AAXX, that will be AAA, here 2A and then here one single A. So mingling of these and here 1X, here 2X, so AAAXXX. Okay, I think so this is the triploid female gananana. Just what we take in the initial time, that only. And then next one, AX crossed by the AAX. So in this time AAAXX, and then AX crossed by the fertilized by the AXXX. This is the condition. As simultaneously AY containing sperm cell, if it is fertilized by the these either any one of the gametes of female, this is the condition. First one AAXY, second one AAXXY, third one AAAXY, and then AAXXY. Okay. Now these are the filling of these boxes are very easy, but identification of sex determination, that is a difficult. So according to the our first these first column concept, sex determination of Drosophila depends upon the which thing, nana, any Y chromosome involvement is there? No. So we want to consideration in the counting of X chromosomes and then number of sets of autosomes. Basing on that, we will give the justification of the sex determination. So in the first column, in the first box, what are the things, how many number of X chromosomes? XX, I mean 2. So 2 by AA, how many sets of autosomes are there? 2 sets of autosomes are there, 2 by 2, correct na? So 2 by 2 ratio, how it is 1. So when that ratio between the X chromosomes and then autosomal sets, it become a 1, that indicates the female, okay? Then come to the next one. AAAXXX, 3 by 3 kadarana, number of sets of X chromosomes, so number of chromosomes of X 3, and then number of sets of autosomes are 3 by 3. So this is also indicates 1, ratio is 1. So this organism also female. And then next AAAXX, so how many number of chromosomes in this box? 2. And then how many number of sets of autosomes? 3, 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 here, it is a 0.6 will become none. The ratio, when you divided these things 2 by 3, it will form to the 0.6. 0.6 indicates which sex I will tell. For clarity, this is a suspense. Okay, then AAXXX. So 3 by 2, 3 X chromosomes are there and then 2 autosomes sets are there. So 3 by 2, it is indicates the ratio between these X and the autosomes 1.5. So here one indicates what it is. One indicates a female character. If ratio more than one means that is also female, but super female. Super female means don't think much more deeply. Super female means it is a female, but it is a sterile. Okay. So infertility. It suffered by the infertility. Okay. So here this is the one by more. If the ratio between the X chromosomes and the autosome sets more than one, that indicates a super female. So one is indicates a female nature. Then now come to the bottom box. X A Y mingled with A X. If A A X Y time, how many sets of how many number of X chromosomes? One. And then how many number of autosomal sets? Two. 1/2 kada. 1/2 ratio 0.5 kada na. So here by the this 0.5 time it indicates a male character. Male character. But here there is no significance of the Y. So if you take Y chromosome is a plain important role in the sex determination, continuation of explanation time you will get some clarity. In the next column, AAXXY, this is also having the Y chromosome. Now finally, this organism want it to express sex determination by male character. But according to the Bridges theory, how many number of chromosomes are there here? Two. And then how many number of sets of chromosomes are there? Autosomal sets are two. 2/2, 1. So here these organism instead of the male one, it is a female, because of we want to consider two only X chromosomes and autosomes, neglect the Y chromosome. So even though Y chromosome it is present in the body, it is not significant role in the sex determination. So that's why based on that this is a female. And then AAAXY. So this condition, how many sets of X chromosomes, how many number of X chromosomes? One. And then how many number of autosomal sets? Three. So 1/3, it is indicated as 0.3, the ratio, correct na? So here this ratio below than 0.5, correct na? When the ratio below than 0.5, it is indicates male but super male. That is also sterile. How the super female is a sterile, like the same way the super male also sterile. And then next one, last AAXXY. Here also Y chromosome is there, even though it is not male, because of the ratio between these X and Y, X and autosomes, just 2/2 will come. 2/2 indicates the ratio will become a 1. So this organism also Y. So by the understanding of these pinhead board, we concluded one thing. Y chromosome present in the organism, even though that organism not at a get male characteristics. So male characteristics of Drosophila organism depends upon the ratio. So one indicates a female, 0.5 indicates the male. If above than one, that is a super female. If the below than 0.5 ratio, that is a super male. Sir, someplace you forget about 0.6. So now this is a intermediate percentage of ratio of the 1 and 0.5. How much? 0.6 kadanna. So 0.6 containing ratio indicates that organism is a intersex. Intersex. It contains the both organism characteristics, both sexual characteristics. So such a chances are also is there. So finally, according to the genetic balance theory, the statement, if you understand that word genetic balance theory, according to the genetic balance theory, what he said, gene balancing, how many genes are on the X chromosomes, how many genes are on the autosomes. Okay, basing on that balancing of the autosomal and then X chromosomal genes, we can say sex determination. That is a thing. Okay, sir, what about human beings? Okay, the beginning of chromosomal theory time, AAXX, AAXY is an example for Drosophila and human beings. Kadana. So, what about regarding human beings means human being Y chromosome. Human being Y chromosome contains a significant genes. That gene names SRY genes. Statement is very important. Nana SRY genes. These genes are responsible for male characteristics. So here in the human beings, male character genes are located on the Y chromosomes. That is the reason Y chromosome play an important role. For example, if that SRY genes instead of the Y chromosome, it is located in the some other chromosomes, so Y chromosome in the human beings also it is a negligible only. So by the evolutionary factor, by the anatomical arrangement in the DNA factors, so these genes are located on the Y chromosome. That is a significant. Okay, that is important. So in the human being, Y chromosome is responsible for male characteristics. That is a thing. Okay, up to now genetic balance theory completed. Then next one, haplodiploidy. You know about, very well known about haplodiploidy. Haplodiploidy type of sex determination we seen in the honeybees and then ants and wasps. These are the small insects in arthropoda organisms. Correct now. So here that wasp, ant and honeybees are showing the haplodiploidy. Haplodiploidy are some of the organisms in the condition of the haploid condition. Some of the organisms in the condition of diploid condition. Which organisms in haploid, which organisms are diploid? Before that, here if you take honeybees, honey hive contains the three type of honeybees. One is a queen and workers and drones. These three type of all are honeybees only, but basing on their functions, we classify queen and then workers belongs to diploid condition, drones are belongs to haploid condition. Okay, so when the organism of honeybee belongs to diploid condition, that organism belongs to female. Okay, if the honeybee belongs to haploid condition, that honeybee belongs to male. Okay, so here the sexual determination depends upon the how many that condition, diploid or haploid, that will decide. So here female honeybee having the 16 pairs of chromosomes, 16 pairs, nothing but diploid, nothing but 32 chromosomes. And then here male organism, male honeybee contains the 16 chromosomes. Okay, so you got the point. Diploid condition time 16 pairs and the haploid condition 16 chromosomes, not at pair condition. So here these pair condition female organisms at the time of the gametogenesis, they are undergoing the meiosis process. By the meiosis process, the chromosomes number will decrease, reducing formation of gametes. So haploid condition eggs will be produced. Okay, some number of haploid condition eggs are produced in the females. They are producing, especially queen is a more important. Okay, here queen only responsible for production of the eggs. What about workers? Means workers does not involving in the production of the eggs. Simply they are working for collecting of the nectar from the different flowers, okay, to collecting to in the converted into the honey also, whatever it is. So totally queen is a more responsible for production of the haploid eggs. Simultaneously in the drones or males, they are also following the production of the spermatogenesis, but spermatogenesis will not show anything meiosis, because of if meiosis happened in the drones or males, already male organism of the honeybee containing the haploid number of chromosomes, haploid condition. In the haploid condition, again meiosis happened, means automatically chromosome number will be reduced up to 8, correct na? So for avoiding that one, here these haploid condition drones are following the mitotic division, normal cell division. By the normal cell division, without reductional division, it produces the haploid sperms, no doubt. Okay, now haploid sperm cells are produced, haploid eggs are produced. Okay, now for example, for calculation wise I am saying, Nana, for example, if the female queen is producing the 100 eggs, in that 100 eggs, 50 eggs are fertile by the sperms. 50% of the eggs are fertile by the sperms. So which are the eggs are fertile by the sperms, those and all again become a diploid condition. So if diploid condition indicates which organisms are female, correct na? And then still 50% of the eggs is not yet fertilized. So which are the eggs are not yet fertilized? Those and all eggs undergoing the parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis, it will also become an adult one. But that all adult ones of the honeybees become the male drones. So here, fertilized eggs, unfertilized eggs. The fertilization will deciding factor to sex determination. If the fertilization happens, means that indicates female genders, female honeybees were produced. Unfertilized eggs will be become a male in the process of the parthenogenesis. So that is the reason males are in the form of haploid condition, females in the form of diploid condition. You know one thing, that here queen only major role. Workers are not at major role in the formation of the eggs. Unfortunately, queen is died. If you take one hive, in the total hive, some thousands of honeybees are there. In the thousands of honeybees, only one honeybee act as a queen. Which honeybee act as a queen mean a particular one significant food, royal jelly, which female worker organism honeybee is at that royal jelly, that will be become a queen. That means nothing but if the one female worker at that royal jelly, the female organism ovaries will be do function. So that ovaries onwards egg production will start. So that based on the royal jelly. Okay, that you should be remember. This is about haplodiploid. Here one silly thing I will be explain. In the honeybees, male honeybees does not have father, but they have the grandfather. Without father involvement, they are producing. So no father, they are having the grandfather. Think it, you will get idea why I said this statement. And then here, up to now we discussed sexual determination depends upon the chromosomes or maybe genes of the X chromosomes and autosomes. And now we discussed about haploid diploid condition. And some of the organism sexual determination basing on the environment. See, in the column of the side in this place, I mentioned basis of the environmental factors also. See, some of the examples I will give. That is a crocodile, turtle, and these organisms, the temperature or where they are located. Here, these organism, first one, Bonilia. Bonilia organism, after fertilization of the sperm cell and ova, fertilized eggs will be going to the bottom of the water. Okay, lack of light intensity, lack of temperature, they are attaching to some of the substratum. So which of the fertilized eggs are attached to the substratum, those organisms or everything will become a female. But some of the eggs, they are located on the water surface area. Okay, so after fertilization, which eggs are located on the water surface area, those organisms, those eggs will become a male. So here, sexual determination depends upon the environment, where they are habitat. As like crocodile, if the crocodile eggs, they are maintained in the under 30 or below than 30 degrees centigrade, that eggs will become a female. If the temperature is 34 degrees or more than 34, it become a eggs will become a male. And as like turtles also, if the 28 degrees centigrade and nearby that temperature, that eggs, fertilized eggs will become a male. Simultaneously, 31 degrees centigrade's temperature influence the eggs modified into the female. So here different individual sexual determination depends upon the several factors. What on our syllabus, for NEET syllabus, what they given, that only we discussed. Okay, let me, I think so you understand the concept. Let me wait the next video regarding mutation. Okay, Nana, thank you.